Hey everyone, today we're going to be focusing on bridge series one. This is suitable for all levels, so we're going to be basically looking at the fundamentals of a bridge and how to engage the correct muscles and make them stronger to create the best bridge you possibly can. Of course, if something is too intense, please decrease the intensity or just skip it and then try again the next time. Alright, so the only thing that you're going to be needing is a weight, so you can use anything that's heavy, from an ankle weight to hand weight, preferably not dumbbells because they might actually take you way too far back. And otherwise you can use a water bottle or anything. Be creative, it's locked down. Use what you can. Alright. First thing we're gonna do is get started with some hip circles. We're gonna do 8 in each direction. So we're gonna do big circles. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Other way, 8, 7, 6, 5, and 4, 3, 2, and 1. We're going to be swinging our arms across and open. 2, and open, 3, open, 4, and open, 5, open, 6, open, 7, and 8, 2 more, 9, and 10, good, shake it out. We're going to be swinging our arms up to the ceiling, and you want to let the ribcage pop. So just from the side, what that will look like is that. Alright, so it's a very rebound kind of action. So it's like, BAM! Yeah, you got that. Alright, then I do 10 of those, keeping the arms nice and relaxed, but straight and strong at the same time. You're lifting up for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Good job, guys. Next, we're going to go onto our hands and knees, making sure that everything is stacked from your wrists, elbows, and knees, as well as your knees and your hips are in the same line. We're going to be doing some cat-cows, lifting up for 1, and pressing up 2, looking all the way up. And out for 2, and pressing out. And 3, and out. And 4, and out. And 5, and out. And 6, and out. 4 more, and 7. So we're going to go down and up for 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and 5, and 6, and 7, 8, 9, and 10. So the other way for 10. Nineteen, eighteen, seventeen. Breath in and lifting up. two, one, and onto your elbows for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and lowering down. Just keep the hips to shake up from side to side. Good job. Next one that we're going to do, we're going to be doing backwards sit-ups. I call them upper body lifts or back-ups. So what you're going to do is you're going to place your feet nice and wide. For some reason, that helps. You're going to place your hands on the side of your head and you're going to lift up as far as you can. We're going to do that for 6. So we're lifting up. 1. And 2. And 3. And down, 4, down 2 more, 5, down, and 6, down. Good job. Just push up into a cobra again, and you'll feel that your cobra has gotten a little bit further this time. It's amazing what such a tiny little kind of exercise can do. So you can do it in between if you need to, just to keep the strength up. Good job, guys. From there, just push back into a child's pose. Holding in for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And relax. Okay, guys. The next one that we'll be doing is C curve activation. So this will be referring to your upper back. What usually happens is when people do back bends, they tend to use their lower back, which is what we do not want, because remember, the lower part of your back is quite squishy and it's a very, very, very sensitive piece of the spine. So, to teach you to activate on top, we're going to take our weight. You can use any weight that you would prefer. My one is quite heavy because I prefer heavy weights. Alright, so we're going to take our arms up. You're going to think of taking the weight to take your shoulders away from your ears. And you're going to think of pushing the butt out, lifting the chest, looking back. And you're going to hold it there for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You're going to stay there. You're going to lift up, try and go a little bit further, and hold for 5. 4, 3, 2, 1, reaching up and over, further, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and relax, have a moment to breathe. I know, that is a strange feeling, right? So you try not to use the lower back, you want to use the upper back. That's why I say reach up and over, because what happens is if you just go here and bend, you see my lower back is being used. So when I say up and over, you want to go up to activate in there. All right, let's go for another set. So we're looking up, shoulder way behind the ears, chest goes forward, we're looking back, you want to hold there for 4, 3, 2, 1, up and over, holding 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and further, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and coming up. Whew, that is quite a workout, right? So, going onto your knees, you're going to have your knees about hip-width distance apart. Of course, if you do want to go wider, then it is easier, okay? So we're going to use the same principle that we just applied for the C-curve activation. We're going to do that to lower down to back and control it up. When you're controlling it up, you really want to push forward with the hips and try not to do like some kind of swimming situation, because then you want to fall. I mean, it would be funny, but not really. No, it would not be funny. All right, but let's get started, guys. So you're going to go up, let the weight take you. Going to reach up and over, that over. Back. And one more round, hold it for 5 seconds. Reaching up and over. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And up. Good. Take a moment just to wiggle it out from side to side. And we will not be using the weights. Now we're going to be doing the same thing, but without the weight. For this, you want your arms to be close to your ears, but you want your armpits to be facing the front. So you don't want this kind of super close position because you create this bent elbow. You want it nice and tall and open. So think that you've got something like shooting out of your armpits, if that makes sense. So you're just going to do 4, and you'll see that this has improved since we've used the weights. All right? And you're reaching up and over for 1. And up. Good. And up and over for 2.
Try and hold for 20 seconds. If you don't make
let's do it all together. And sometimes also, if it does help you, you can count it out loud so that you do encourage your breathing as well. Alright, let's go. So you can end your bridge any way you want.
Just get everything shake out. This is your time.
See you guys soon.